I'm Abdi from Kenya, born in Kenya, Somalia, and Ethiopia. I would like to touch a topic on radicalization and how, based on my experience, how I thought can be mitigated. When you hear radicalization, it sounds extreme word. Can be positive or negative, depends how you use. But I'm talking about the negative extremes and radicalization. And that's what I mean. It might be emotional, but this is a fact. I have to live with it. And it is the right time, the right moment, the right meaning, with the right audience to share, and I'm very humble to share with you. As alleged by different scholars, there are different driving factors of radicalization from where I come from. One is marginalization, where young people believe that the government doesn't recognize them. And they elbowed out in terms of infrastructure development. So the only alternative is to create extreme behavior to get the answer. Inadequate access to education. You know, education is life. That means they are doomed. They are susceptible to different ideologies, where different ideas, extreme ideas, being seeped into their brains. And they thought, the much you kill, the bigger heaven is waiting. I have a photo here, one by the name Ibrahim Muhammad. Ibrahim comes from where I come from. He comes from my dad. We stay in the same town. Is a shining young leader. He was radicalized. Guess what he did? He was killed that way by the armed forces. Why? He killed, was behind Mastermind 148, young, energetic, brilliant leaders who can change this world. And that was a moment in our dark days. Those kids are my friends. They're from Mandela. You see, rest in peace, Mandela. Teachers, friends, family members who might be eating together in the same dining table. Some of my colleagues were asking me where all these photos are. Why then this? You'll find three photos. Back all the days of the camel hire. And those can see the photo in the camel. And I was around 8 years, my first time I ate rice. Why? Because I used to take milk. I never knew rice. Then I had the passion of doing peace and security. And one day, one time, Vice President, Kenya Vice President gave me, I was given actually the National Peace Prize, Kenya 2011, and he shook my hand and told the young man, you did us proud. The following subsequent year, 2012, I was given head of state commendation by His Excellency, the former President of Kenya, Mwai Kibaki. These photos gave me courage to proceed ahead. Give me passion to do what I'm doing. Specific with the camel photo, if I was not given that kind of opportunity to go to school, maybe, who knows, I could have been a radical. That is now the light of education. But still, there are hopes from where I come from. In Mandela, Kenya, Ethiopia, and Somalia, the best watermelon and oranges is grown there, it's transported. It's transported to United Arab Emirates, one of the best oranges in Eastern Central Africa. We are about in Kenya, Ethiopia, and Somalia, still there are agricultural opportunities. But there need some policy frameworks, some enabling policies to make it happen. Some of the key strategic interventions that I was thinking might move the narrative ahead is enabling policy, lobby the stakeholders and see how best you can provide a platform for these young upcoming right leaders in terms of education access, in terms of job opportunities and political representation, because they feel in their heart one way or the other they are not presented. Then how I can change the behavior change, because what is in your heart is more than what you do in action, because heart matters. How can I change these proliferated ideas from across the border? I would like to end in this quote that says, in darkness, there is a light. And how do I achieve? I will achieve through the power of place, the power of idea. Thank you for listening.